showing the process of a social media audit. I have these two wicked tools, like all of this data from, and it was weird because the one of the tools I had someone reach out to me through Gmail and was like, "Hey, I saw a demo of yours, but I can't log in." And it took me a while to figure it out, but it's Inc 361, and it's really great. It gives you all this data on social media. So I've already implemented my personal brand because I have a few different ones on Instagram, and it gives me like all of my content, like how many things I posted, which is kind of funny, how many likes I've received, comments received, all that good stuff. And like from the first time I posted to like my recent, you can see kind of like the growth. And then how many posts per year, like I was really on a good one. I was all about it. More than one post a day. But it doesn't have like recent. Oh, we're 17. I don't see it over here, but yeah. What time of the day is best to post? Sunday fun day, of course, and always in the later because I'm more of a night owl. And then geotagging is super important, but sometimes I forget. What is the most liked post? So you can see like what content works. Apparently the selfies do justice. Comments, most comments. So that's really cool. Filters, all that. But then there's another that I'm using to kind of filter the data and see what your audience looks like. I can't remember exactly if this shows you who's your audience. Yeah. It makes sense. Like, I just linked it back to the account, so it's not giving me everything that I want right now, but coming soon. And this second tool kind of tells me like what is the most chatter. So for me, for some reason, I don't know why, but possibly I was trending a lot in Havana. Detroit makes sense because I'm always talking about it. But this number is wrong because the number now is closer to here. And then I mean, that's kind of what it shows as far as my statistics on Inc 361. It's closer to that number. I'm getting these random messages on Instagram. Audience credibility, da da da. Popular hashtag, location my country, USA, Indonesia, because I live in Bali, and Colombia, because I stay in Medellin a lot. Influencer interest, wedding, which I don't know how. I would think more of it would be product-based or brand-based. Travel and tourism and aviation makes a lot of sense, because I'm always traveling. Art and design make a lot of sense. Detroit, Bali, LA, Medellin, New York. Pew! What hashtags I'm using. This is great, and you can even open it up and kind of see. And that's kind of interesting to have so that you know what you should be using when you're writing your content. The mentions, gender, if this is important to you, I mean, then you can kind of like see exactly like who is your audience. Are they white? Are they male? Are they female? Are they international? Like, what's their age group? Lookalikes, which I'm gonna get to because this is quite interesting because lookalikes to me are the same as if you would go to someone's profile. So I'm gonna go to my other page. And I'm gonna click this arrow. So these would be like lookalikes. So most interacted, similar profiles. So this looks like it could be a little bit older, even though I just pulled the report, because it's like, it's kind of off on the followers, and some of the data is a little bit outdated. But I like this. So I can take what I have here and I can start constructing like, all right, where do I start? What does my audience look like? And it's just kind of gives you a direction on like where you should head as far as content curation, what profiles you should be searching when you're looking for people that are like-minded. Like if I put in my hashtag life of Missy DI. There's a lot of posts here. These are my top posts. And then there's recent posts. Like, I know which ones are me. Obviously, you can see. But then you can see like others that are using my hashtag. Look at this is me. And this is my agency hashtag. Wonder why they thought that that would have been a good idea. Same again. But yeah, most of this is mine, and you should always have your own hashtag because that's how you can sort of measure success and see if you're going to start trending if other people use it. But you can also see like your posts about your brand, so specific to you to make you look and stand unique. Yeah, that looks about right. Cool. So this is kind of like a rundown of what it would look like for an audit. And I even like exported all of this and put it in this beautiful format so that you could just look at it. It's nice to have, especially when you're working in like cutting merging trends and you need to see like whose profile is like yours, audience information. But I try to take it even one step further and I ask for screenshots on your analytics in your Instagram so I can kind of compare and see what's converting, and my phone's always dying. This last week I was ill for 2 days, so I wasn't really active on social media. So you can kind of see that as far as my numbers are a little bit down. So yeah, I let like 26 more posts last week. So I need to start pumping it up. Okay. If you want a social media audit on your Instagram, you want to take this data and do something with it and just look it over, just give me a holler. I could probably hook you up with something. All right, ciao, ciao for now.